Jags Titans preview.
Act 1, Scene 1.
Yo, what's up, everyone? Welcome to another episode of Titans Tube. I know what you're thinking. This is the Titans and Jags preview for their Thursday night game, and it's only like an hour until the game. Who cares? Listen to this episode, because we're going to tell you how the Titans are going to beat the Jags in just a little over probably an hour by the time this video is uploaded. Before we get to that, though, want to shout out to our sponsors, hang10.com. Use the code TITANS2 for 10% off your order. Get your Mari Gota shirt. Get your sweet Aloha Spirit shirt. Look at that. My hand fits perfectly right there.
I can't wait to see which one Caleb gets me for Christmas.
You need one because this is not a Hang 10 shirt. This is just normal Titans apparel.
Don't buy that one.
So lame.
Like, compared to, like, this is a comparison thing. Like, look at how lame mine is compared to y'all's.
Dope shirts to not, I mean, still a Titan shirt, so kind of cool. Go Titans.
Could be worse.
Also, shout out to Backyard Dog Barbecue Sauce. Check out Justin's hat and description below. Link in the description below for more info on that. Also, big shout out to all of our patrons. And if you want to listen to this episode as a podcast, you know, on your way to the game tonight or at the game if you're already tailgating, you can on iTunes. Subscribe to Titans Tube as a podcast. Okay, guys, we're going to do a very abbreviated preview episode here. Jaguars at 4-8 after they just beat the Colts, though. Big divisional win for them and shut them out. Coming to town, facing the Titans on Thursday night. Titans coming off a home win against Sunday. Comeback against the Jets to move us to 6-6, still in the playoff race. We're just going to go straight to keys and predictions for the game from all three of us. This is Amy, if you don't know who that is. That's Justin. I'm Caleb. Justin, I'm going to toss this one to you first.
Oh, okay.
Give me some keys to the game here.
Oh, man.
What are you looking at?
The pressure's on.
Titans versus the Jags.
The pressure's on. Also, shout out Amy for joining us for this preview episode.
Thank
she normally
Justin.
Doesn't. She's
oh
usually
gosh.
Just our picks.
Y'all are so sweet. Oh,
okay, well, we didn't need that. I was just.
You want to see more?
Clap
you like that?
No. Yeah.
No.
But yes, good to have you breaking this game down with us, Amy. Okay, so have the Jaguars defense turned a corner and found themselves from a year ago shutting out the Colts? That was wonderful to watch. I think I've said this before, but that's got to be my favorite thing that the Jags have ever done in my time as a football fan. But I hope that's just a once in a season kind of performance for them, because if they can do that to Luck and the Colts, I fear what they might be able to do to our very inconsistent and suspect offense. But you know, we have had the Jags number in the past couple years. I mean, you look at that Week 2 game, we still only put up 9 points to get them, and it was somehow good enough to win the game.
Uh-huh.
Will Cody Kessler make a difference for their offense? I hope not. It shouldn't. But we have always found a way to make Bortles just play his worst games of his career when he plays us. Having said that, I think the key to this game has got to be on the offense and taking care of the ball and maintaining the field position battle. I think this is going to be a super low-scoring game. It's going to be one of those laughable, ha-ha, Titans-Jags, another crap fest. But it's going to be a defensive struggle. And I think it's got to be on Mariota. He's got to be able to take care of the ball and not give their offense anything, much like he did last week against the Jets by throwing a pick six. No pick sixes, please, Mariota.
Please.
Yes.
If there's anything our offense cannot do, I was just going to say, if there's anything our offense cannot do, it's give the other team points. Because we can't score that many points.
Yes, exactly. And, I mean, I feel like this is going to be an ugly game. And we're going to see a lot of punts. And that's okay. I'm okay with punting the ball. It's going to happen. I feel like it's going to happen a lot in this game tonight.
Brett Kern needs to do something.
Brett Kern's got to be on his game, pinning those punts deep in Jags territory to make it difficult for their offense. As far as Leonard Fournette goes, we play pretty good against Leonard Fournette. He has his really good games, but since he's been in the league, we've been able to shut him down pretty well. And hopefully we continue that, because our run defense has been suspect this year. That's another thing to keep an eye on, is how we're able to contain Fournette. But as long as the offense takes care of the ball, we win the field position battle, and then we, you know, sneak, get some points when we can. I don't want to be too aggressive. If there's like a 4th-and-3 on the Jags 10-yard line or something, just kick the field goal.
Very specific.
We just need the points.
Specific.
I don't want to see over aggressive.
What about 4th-and-4?
Almost said malarkey.
4 on the 11-yard line. Would you kick the field goal or go for it?
Or 4th-and-2 on the 9.
I would go for that.
Okay.
All the way.
Just making clear.
No.
Okay.
No. Just take the points. Even on like a 4th-and-goal from the 1, I hate to say it, but I would kind of just want us to see us kick a field goal. But anyway, I think we're going to win this game 13-10.
Ooh.
Take care of the ball, and we'll get it done.
I didn't even ask for predictions yet. I just asked for keys, and you gave me a whole keychain full of them.
I thought I was doing both at once.
No, that's cool. Thanks for your prediction. No. Now, Amy, I'm going to toss it to you. What are you going to be the keys for tonight for the Titans to get the win?
All right, so this is it. The Jags are not going to win this game. Either the Titans are going to win it or the Titans are going to lose it. So, in order for the Titans to win it, Justin, I agree, take care of the ball. That was something that we did not do very well last week, so it's very fresh in my mind right now. I really think we need to find a key is going to be just like finding some kind of rhythm on offense. Marcus has to play with confidence. I feel like whenever we see him play with confidence, the team thrives almost. I don't really know what the difference in him playing with confidence and not confidence is. Like, how come sometimes he does and sometimes he doesn't? But you know what? He's just got to go in there, be confident with his decisions to either throw or run it, be confident with his throws. I think Deion Lewis needs to have a good game for us to win as well. I really just feel like everything, especially on our offense, needs to be running as a well-oiled engine, needs to be running as well as they can. Everyone needs to be playing their best. There's little room for error. I think the defense can definitely handle the Jags, even if there is some error, even if we let some big plays get by, let Fournette, you know, get a big run or a big play here and there. I still feel like the defense is tight enough to where that's not just going to kill it for us. I think the offense is the one that needs to play well and continue to play well for all four quarters, not just for two, not just for one, and everyone.
Not just for one half.
Three.
What about one half of a quarter?
That might be okay.
Okay.
What about 3.5 quarters?
So yeah, consistency on offense, confidence on offense, and then turnovers. Turnovers.
Justin already gave his score prediction. What are you predicting, Amy? You predicted the Titans win in the picks video, so you better not flip-flop here.
Oh, that'd be weird. No, I am going to pick the Titans to win. I think it'll be 16-10.
16-10, okay.
Yeah, not the most boring game in the world, but, you know.
Titans get another touchdown and miss the extra point. I like what all you guys said. Obviously, it's a big divisional game. Titans have owned the Jags the previous few meetings. Amy, I liked what you said. There's going to be little room for error, especially when it comes to our offense. And I do believe the key kind of lies with Mariota. What kind of Mariota are we going to see this game? And I think a subtle key to that is what kind of offensive line play are we going to see this game?
Yikes.
Especially after the first half against the Jets, Quentin Spain got benched. A lot of people calling for Dennis Kelly, Corey Levin to come in over Jack Conklin. What kind of lineup and matchups are we going to see tonight from the offensive line? And I think that plays has a direct effect on Mariota's confidence. We've given up a sack on the first possession like more times than not this season, which I think immediately makes Marcus start looking down to his feet if he feels some pressure. And he can't look upfield and throw the ball. If that's the case, knocks him out of a rhythm. So I want the offensive line to play well. I think that's just the key from here on out for the season.
Yeah.
And I think that directly is a catalyst for Mariota having confidence, having time in the pocket, and not looking panicked, and being able to hit Taywan Taylor deep. Yeah. So those are my keys. I think our defense, even though this team's been wildly inconsistent this year, our defense has been the least inconsistent of the inconsistencies we've had. So with Cody Kessler back there, I'm not really looking for the Jags to come out and put up a whole bunch of points. I think we can get this one, you know, winning probably 17-13 here. We might get another touchdown late. But, yeah, it's going to be a tough fought. Low-scoring game like the Titans and Jags games always are. But Titans in their last, 17 games at home are now 14-3. So I can't not pick against the Titans at home here. That's give them props for that. So I got the Titans winning tonight. What did I say, 17-13?
Yeah.
Boom. Yeah.
That is good. That is a good point. Their defensive line is I'm very stressed about that against our offensive line and how they've looked. So – that's a huge
don't stress.
Key. Offensive
don't stress.
Line has to have a great, great game for protection.
Yeah, don't stress. Yeah.
But yeah, I like you guys. I like you
Man,
guys' prediction.
I like you, dude.
I like you.
You guys are cool too, bro. You're cool.
Thanks for having
guys,
me on.
You know what? We like each other, and we like talking about the Titans. We should start a Titans YouTube channel and podcast. Wouldn't that be fun?
We should.
You think people would like it? I think they would love it.
I think they would love it.
What a great
anyways, we're going to cut this episode short. Those are our keys and predictions for the game. Thank you for watching. Thank you for being patient with us these last few weeks as we struggle to get all of our weekly videos out on time or at all. Mm-hmm. Always make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and give your keys and predictions in the comment section below. If you're a Jags fans, get the fuck out of here.
Oh no.
Peace out.
We were good. We were great right until that last sentence. We've
round of applause.
We've crossed the censorship line.
Love the censorship.
Justin's reaction is my favorite. He goes, "Oh no."
Anything left to add? Is that okay?
Oh no.